Hey guys, this is Caleb. I'm just gonna do a quick maintenance video on the spark arrestor. Canam recommends that you clean your spark arrestor every 15 kilometers, which is 1,000 miles,
or 50 hours,
whichever comes first. But that's for severe riding and dusty and muddy, heavy loads type of conditions. But for just more laid back trail riding type of conditions, they recommend every 3,000 kilometers, which is 2,000 miles, or 100 hours, whichever comes first. Now I'm at 47 hours right now and 403 miles. So I am due to clean my spark arrestor.
And I definitely fall under the muddy, heavy loads conditions because
I've been doing a lot of muddy riding. I did some really intense races. I did three of them. Those are 2.5 hour races roughly. And I've cracked this open. So I've already pulled off the tip of the muffler here. It's got three Allen bolts in it. Size 5 millimeter. Kind of a pain in the butt to get to this one up here. I use this type of Allen wrench. And I think if you want, you can actually pull this down to make it a little easier to get to by popping out these two bolts here. Okay, but I didn't do that. I just sprayed a little WD-40 on there and went at it. Here we are. So I'm gonna pull this out and see how it looks. Okay, that is really bad. A lot of carbon built up. Woo, messy. I'm gonna shoot some air in there. But look at this. This thing is pretty well clogged. Like, I should have did this at 25 hours. Okay. So I'm gonna get this cleaned up. All right, it's gonna be fun getting this bad boy cleaned up. I can't believe how bad that is. It's so bad. I got me some nice little wire brushes here. Oh, it's nasty stuff, man. Woo, dang. I'm gonna get some air and blow that out. There is so much buildup on the inside of here. It's actually like a buildup. This is gonna grind it right out. Yeah, that's pretty darn good. Now, it's not recommended that these are replaced unless they're damaged in some way. And this is metal, and it's pretty solid, pretty durable feeling. So I'm not worried about it. And it's only a few years old now. So there it is. It's actually all cleaned off.
Just wire this off a little bit.
And the gasket that comes on there seems to be fine. So I'll reuse it. Eventually, I'll probably get a new exhaust on this thing anyway, so. But yeah, just throw it back on there. As such, I'm just gonna spray these off. They're a little dirty, a little rusty. It was a little tough to unscrew them. It's like the threads are tight, you know? So this might help me get them back on. Clean them up a little bit. These also had little washer things on them. Pop it back in. And it feels good doing proper maintenance. Because if I wouldn't have pulled that off of there, I don't know what it would have done, but it can't be good, right? Messes with your pressure and everything. I'll have to see if it runs better. Yeah, these are a little bit of a pain in the butt to get to, but it's worth it. Get it off there.
clear it out at least every 50 hours. Not a big deal, but regular maintenance is important. So I do it because I want to take care of this machine. I love this machine. This machine is my baby. Bought her brand new and I want to keep her running nice. You know, that spark arrestor is kind of a pain in the butt, but you know, I don't know how much it prevents forest fires personally, but pretty sure it's a legal thing. It's supposed to be on there. And it's also a screen so that nothing big can get up in there. So I'm gonna leave it on for now. Okay. Let me know what you think in the comment section. I am curious how many people just pull these screens off because they don't want them on there. I am genuinely curious, but it feels good to have it cleaned off. It's nice to know your maintenance schedule so that you keep things up to par. And I'm not gonna lie, this bolt up here is a pain in the butt. Ratchet on, and you don't have a ratchet. I do got some ratchet bits, but they'd be too long to get up in there with. So I'm doing it all by hand. I'm using these pliers to help me turn this Allen wrench. These bolts go on kind of tough. They got tight threads. All right, good enough. Now, let's see how it runs. That runs better. I made the mistake of not making a video of it running beforehand because I wasn't planning on making a video, to be honest. And I really wish I had that before now because I'm pretty sure it's better. All right. So, hey, if you like this content, hit the like button, subscribe, leave a comment. I learn a lot from guys in the comments and I like the feedback. I like to hear from you. Let me know what you think and see what you can add to the conversation. All right.